Richarlison, Kulusevski, Sess, Sessegnon, any other news?
Yeah, and about Sessegnon, and today he didn't train with us. Yeah, he has a little problem and is not available for tomorrow's game. About Ricci and Deki, they had a train session, and I have one day to make the best decision and to pick them into the start 11.
I don't think I'll see you before January, so obviously the January transfer window will dominate in a few weeks' time. Will you be speaking to Fabio and Daniel about new signings in January? Because you always say clubs around the top four will be strengthening too, and Tottenham have to continue to strengthen. Mm-hmm. Do you believe this football club needs maybe one, two, three more additions in January?
But honestly, and until now we didn't speak, but for sure after the first part of the season, it's right to have a meeting, no? To have a meeting with the club and then to discuss about the positive things, about the negative things, and the way that we can improve. And then we'll see what we can do. It depends always of the possibility, no? And about the club to. Also the ambition that, but for sure we speak and yeah. Also to have a good evaluation, no? About this first start of the season, where I have seen a lot of positive things, but you know that injuries and to play every three days. I think we struggled a lot, and I think in the future we have to try to improve, no, and to be better, to face this type of situation. I think this could be a good way, in my opinion. Then you know very well that we have to discuss with the club and to make the best decision.
There's been so many fixtures. It's the season like no other. I bet you need a break. Like a break as well, just to recharge your own batteries.
Yeah.
Is it still your plan, though, maybe to talk about your own contract near the end of the season, or do you think maybe at Christmas time when you have a break you'll be thinking about it too? Because obviously when it gets to near the end of the season, the players start to wonder your intentions. You know, is there an update on that?
Yeah, but you know very well that my contract expired in June, no, and 30 June, and I think that's until that moment the club has to make the best evaluation also, no, and because I think everything you need to deserve. And for this reason, it will be important to see and the rest of the season, no? What happened, and if we are happy about the improvement that we are doing. And but I think every situation, and it's important to deserve. In my opinion, in my side. It's important for me, professionally. I have to feel that I deserve to have a new contract and to sign a new contract with this club. And I have to feel this. And but for sure, we'll talk with the club and we'll find the best solution.
Thank you. Thanks,
Alex.
Hi, Antonio.
Hi.
Yeah.
I remember very well my first game, and it was a really tough game against Leeds at that time, and I remember very well. But the characteristics are always the same, because We are talking about a team with great energy. They play football with great intensity. They put a lot of pressure. They have a lot of energy. And in this moment, I think that is a really tough opponent, because we are at the last game of this marathon, and we played 13 games. But every game was really, really tough, and we lost a lot of energy and under physically energy and mentally energy. For this reason, tomorrow we have to pay great attention. We prepared the game well to understand that I think that we have to also to pay more attention to be more good defensively, because in the last seven games we conceded in every game goals, and I think this is unusual for us. It means that maybe we have to be more focused, to be more compact, to show compactness during the game. At the same time, to try to get 3 points. But for sure, the game, it won't be easy. And this is the last game. They played less game than us. Also, in the last game, I have seen that the whole team rested. And we want to finish in the best possible way, because to finish with a win would be very important for us, because with a qualification in Champions League, and if you continue to stay in the top four after this first part of the season, it means that you did a really good job. But you know that many players, the strikers, no, and we lost all the strikers, and then also when you lose your strikers, and also you have to change something in your system, and we risked against Nottingham Forest to play without striker, because Harry gave me his availability only the morning, no, of the game. And for sure, you have to try to change something. But, you know, when I have all the players available, I like to play with the 3 strikers. And more an addiction like Perisic, that is not a striker, but is a winger, is an offensive winger. We try to play with the offensive player. But when happened this type of situation, you have to struggle to find the other situation to manage in the best possible way this period.
Hi, Antonio.
Hi.
We're a week out from the start of the World Cup, and obviously Harry Kane, you said the other night Harry Kane was tired, struggled with training, and brought him off after an hour. I don't suppose A, you're going to rest him tomorrow, and B, how much are you looking at your players tomorrow, those who are going to the World Cup, and expecting them still to give absolutely everything, despite the fact that they could get injured and miss the biggest tournament of their life?
But it's normal that the players that played many games, that played every game, are a bit tired. But I don't think a physical tight. I think more mentally you can be a bit tired, because to play every 3 days, to prepare every game, is difficult. Is difficult for me and the staff, no? And to prepare every game in every 3 days in a so short period, and it's normal that some players are tired, but at the same time, I think that we have to finish in the best possible way. And in the last game, and then Harry arrested the last half an hour against Nottingham Forest. It was the same for Perisic. I tried to alternate and to split the fatigue with Pierre and Rodrigo. and Ben Davis was on the bench, and I tried to find a good balance, because I repeat, the effort was really, really a big effort. But tomorrow we have an important game, and 3 points for us are vital, especially because, I repeat, if we are able to finish this first part of the season with an important qualification in Champions League, and then to finish in top four, despite a lot of problems that we had in these 43 days, I think could be really good, and it means that the job that we did is a good job.
You mentioned that it's a good job. You said earlier regarding your contract, it'll be whether or not the hierarchy think you deserve another contract. I mean, that just seems to be a given. I mean, you're one of the best managers in world football. So in terms of that, are you looking at hopefully signing a new deal at the end of the season?
But you know, and I think when you start a path with a club and your dream to stay here for many years, no, to try to build something important, and I think are very important the relationship that you create with your players, the relationship that you create with the club, with the environment around you, and don't forget also the ambitions, because if you are used to play, no, in your career and to fight to win, also it will be very important to match all this situation, and then to. If you are lucky to find all of this situation, and for a coach it's more simple to stay for a project a long term, but you know, in modern football, to find everything of this is not simple. It's not simple, and many times there are problems and problems that. Bring the coach after 2 years, 3 years, to go away or to be sacked, because don't forget that there are two ways, no? Or you decide to go away, or also you could be sacked, yes. And in England, before in England, where you said to when you decided to take in charge one manager, no, and then to give time, a lot of time. Now also in England, I'm seeing that are like Italy, yeah, it's becoming like Italy, yeah. Change when the results are not good, you are ready to change quickly.
Okay, Ali, and then we'll finish with Nick at the back, please.
Yeah. But for sure, every time we speak together, and always there are always a good conversation. Okay, also because the target is only one: to try to improve the club in every aspect. No, on the pitch, outside the pitch, and then to try to find the best solution. In every moment, I think that until now we worked only with this target to improve and to find a good way to bring this club to be competitive. You understand? But I'm understanding very well in these years that. It's not easy. It's not easy because you can improve, but at the same time, you have other teams that they are continuing to improve and to go forward like us or much more than us, because maybe they have I don't know, but more situation to more possibility sometimes, you understand? And for this reason it will be very important to speak, it will be very important to have a good conversation, to understand if we are satisfied for the work that we are doing after 1 year in this first period of this season, and then to understand very well which are the reality possibility for us, no? Which are the reality ambition of the club. And yeah, because I think the truth is very important. It's very important, and we need the club and me to know the truth. Because if you know the truth, and then you can work to find the best solution for the future. Yeah, about Gian Piero, and I think that yeah, before to answer this question, and about Gian Piero, and I want to open and to tell that for us in these 43 days, not only 13 games, but only difficult emotional moment. To lose Gian Piero like person was terrible, not only for me. I have seen also for many players, because many players had a great relationship with him, and I think that someone had a big loss in his heart. But you know, the life is this, and you have to face and to go forward, to move on about Gian Piero. About the situation, about the work, and we continue to work in the same way. And don't forget Gian Piero, I called him when I was appointed in Tottenham, because in the past he was in China, and I worked with Cannavaro, with Fabio Capello, no? And then in the last 1 year, we started to work again. And the work is always the same. For sure, there is a lack of human aspect. Then there is a lack of his experience. There is a lack of his relationship with the players, but you know, it was a big loss for us. But you know, and the life is this, and we had to move on. But Gian Piero, for sure, in these 43 days, I think that yeah. Emotionally, was really, really tough for us this period.
Okay, finish with Nick, please.
Can I just ask what your plans are for the players not going to the World Cup? Do you have friendlies? Some teams are training in places like Dubai to be close to Qatar. Players are coming out of the World Cup. Are you doing something similar?
Yeah, but honestly, and we thought that the players not involved in the World Cup, they could stay at home. Instead, at the last moment, many national teams decided to play two friendly games. And for this reason, now, and yeah, after the game against against Leeds, the players that they have to go to play the World Cup, they go with the national team. The others, they continue to have the training session to go with the national team to have two friendly games. Then they'll have days off to recover. Before, in our idea was to try to find a solution and to go in away from London and to go and to stay in a place in a,